Friends, now we will see how to find the GCD of two given numbers. Okay, we will now find out for a fairly small number, 12, 16. Okay, we will find the GCD of these two numbers. What are the divisors of 12? Of course, 1 is the common divisor for all the numbers. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. Okay. And what is the common divisor for 16? Okay. 1, 2, 3 doesn't divide. 3 doesn't divide 16. So 4 divides 16. Right? 8. Okay. So what are the factors that is common factors here? 2 is a common factor. And 4 is the common factor. We are concerned only with the GCD. That is, we are concerned only with the greatest common factor. What is the greatest common factor here? 4 is the greatest common factor. So, these two numbers, 12 and 16, are very small numbers and it is very easy to find out the GCD of these two numbers. But once we are going into the higher order, so at that time we have to find out how do you find the GCD of any two numbers for a fairly high value. Now we will see what is the GCD of 161, 28. Okay, put it as Q or 1. R2 and this is R. Okay, what is the highest number between 161 and 28? 161 is the highest. Put it under R1. R2 you put as 28. Okay, now 161 and 28. So divide the 161 by 28. So 161 divided by 28, it goes 5 times. So it comes what? 140. 21 is the remainder. Okay, so Q is, quotient is 5 and remainder is 21. Now what we have to do? Okay, now 28 becomes your new numerator and 21 becomes your new denominator. Okay, now what do you do? Now we will again do this one. So 28 is the new numerator and 21 is the new denominator. So how many times it goes? One time it goes 21. So 28 minus 21 is 7. So what happens is quotient part, Q part you put as 1 and remainder part you put it as 7. It doesn't stop here. You have to do this more shifting also. So what is this? 21 becomes your new numerator and 7 becomes your new denominator. So, repeat this process. 21 divided by 7. 3 times it goes. 21 plus 21, 0. So, quotient is 3. Put the quotient as 3 and remainder as 0. Again, do this one, shifting. 27 becomes your new numerator, 0 becomes your new denominator. So, what is 7 by 0? It is not calculable. So, what is the highest common factor? Or, what is the greatest common divisor? 7 is the greatest common divisor. Okay, so this is called the Euclidean algorithm method. So, why are we seeing this? So, the reason is, we are going to see a beautiful concept called as public key cryptography. For understanding the public key cryptography, we have to understand the GCD, we have to understand the quotient, and we have to understand other concepts in prime numbers, etc. So that's the reason I'm just introducing this subject of GCD now. So we'll be following it up with quotient, Euler's quotient function, etc. And then we'll be going into the public key cryptography. What is the use of public key cryptography? Public key cryptography is the basis of the modern banking system. Okay, if you take any credit card or debit card, swipe it somewhere in the shops, malls, or even in the ATM machine, that you are going to use the public key cryptography. But what is the basis of the public key cryptography? The basis of the public key cryptography is the prime numbers. Okay, how we are using the prime numbers, how you are working with prime numbers using the GCD and Euler's torsion function, etc., to securely send, securely communicate over the insecure lines of internet. Okay, this is just an introduction for that. We will see more about this subject later. Thank you. Good day. Bye.